everybody, what's going on? Welcome back to Heavy Metal Model. AUTOart's 118th model of the Nissan GTR circa 1990 replicates one of the most winning combinations on the track in the Japan Touring Car Championship. Now, just because it's a midline Millennium Series release, well, that doesn't mean that they've cut anything short as far as detail and features. Check it out.
When it comes to making scenery-eating monsters, the fellows at Toho Films have nothing on the folks over at Nissan, who built a real-life monster for the street that would take the name Godzilla. Initially, Nissan called the car the Skyline GTR. In its third generation, after skipping a few years between 1973 and 1989, the model returned hairier than ever with added all-wheel drive and the potential to make upward of 600 horsepower in Group A race trim. The car dominated on the street and on the track and still remains a favorite among true Asia market hypo aficionados. All of that will surely come to roost on AUTOart's slick model of the car, seen in this latest trim, decoed as the machine that ran for the Reebok team in 1990. Driven by Masahiro Hashimi and Anders Olofsson to an overall second place in the Japan Touring Car Championship, with one outright win and four second-placed finishes. Typical of AUTOart, there's nothing second place about this Millennium Series model's finish. Every inch of striping, every logo, and every deco on the car's flare-fendered body, save for the outstanding foil-based badges and stock body brand lettering, is done in sharply registered tampos that ride the brilliant white paint and line up perfectly from panel to panel. I imagine that's partly due to the panel's excellent fitment. Despite the car's opening doors, hood, and trunk, for the most part, the seams are dead even and approach the scale correctness of a well-done resin. Add to that some very nicely put-up headlights, deep reflective taillights and backup lights, steel mesh in the grille, and high-grade clear parts for the glazing, and it's a piece that brings the car's shape and colors out very, very well. There are neat multi-piece Volgray wheels at the corners, and these have been equipped with nameless but well-scuffed rubber tires and very nice etched steel brake discs with pass-through calipers. The fronts are steerable from the wheel. Don't try posing them or you break the linkage, and the car rolls well despite close tolerances at the fenders. Under the hood, the Nissan's twin-turbo straight-six is a beauty, with layers of well-cast, well-placed, and pinpoint-decorated detail bits, some of which have been hit with a dazzling metallized finish to replicate the aluminum that made up the radiator, airbox, and some of the intake, all set below the polished cross-brace that helped the 2600cc RB26 engine from pulling the car apart at the shock towers. Go deeper and there is a very well done bits of plumbing and conduit run to secondary fixtures on the fender. Look on the driver's side for the twin turbos themselves. The cabin is tidy and white with a mix of older tech AUTOart bits like the rubber seat harness existing along high end pieces like the hand twisted lashings that secure the electrical cables and air jack lines along the roll cage. The door panels are off-the-shelf stockers and looking good, as is the modified dash with its added-on shift lights, gauges, and rows of buttons in the race-ready center stack. Above it all is a stripped-out roof. Below it is a denuded floor in all its ribbed and braced glory. In a world where trunks are the lowest priority, this one's boot is a boffo exercise in crisp castings, sharp metallized paint, and a slick group of fuel hoses and filters, all set deeply into a surgically clean area wrapped with nearly hair-thin painted-on gasketing. More crazy cool detailing is underneath. In addition to the hard parts for the driveline and lower engine, the car's got a set of soft, flexible orange cooling pipes for the brakes, a brace of oil coolers, and a pair of side dump exhaust with hollow tips, all done in high-grade, well-finished styrene. In those old Toho movies, Tokyo was always one moment away from destruction beneath the heel of some giant mythical beast. This midline AUTOart release celebrates a real world track monster to a degree that's almost scary.
I gotta tell you what I like about AUTOart, and it's pretty much everything. You know, at every price point, these guys seem to really bring a great game to the table. This model, it's a mix of the older AUTOart mold sets, and you can see that in some of the pieces. But what they do with the balance of the model is they bring along some really high-end stuff as far as like those wire ties, those flexible cooling hoses, all that kind of stuff. Just really brings a lot of charm to this piece. This is a wicked cool model car. Really enjoyed checking it out. Hope you enjoyed seeing it too. Hey, if there's a car you want to see on Heavy Metal Models, let me know. Joe at HeavyMetalModels.com. Come on, man. Join us on that Facebook page. Like us on there. We're going to be doing some more contests. We've got a great group of guys there. And of course, please subscribe to us right here on the YouTube channel. This way, when the videos come out, you get an email and you can enjoy them right away. Thanks for being here. I truly do appreciate it. We'll see you soon. Take care.